Hello students, good afternoon. Myself, Dr. Navneet Kumar, working as an associate professor and head in the Department of Processing and Food Engineering at College of Agriculture Engineering and Technology and Anand Agriculture University at Godhra campus. Since we are studying a course, Drying and Storage Engineering, and we already have completed the drying portion, so we will now concentrate on the storage. So before going further, we would discuss what is the real need of storage. Why do we really need storage? The storage is required because the time of production is not same as the time of consumption. For example, we are getting wheat in 1 month duration maximum as a production from the field, and maize we can take two times in a year. But if we talk about the consumption, we daily need wheat or wheat flour for making chapatis. We daily need maize flour for making chapatis and other types of crops are also there, whether these are fruits, vegetables, and certain crops are there. Normally we will concentrate on the storage of cereals, pulses. So if we talk about the storage is an interim and repetitive phase. Why we are saying repetitive phase? Because we need repeat at different locations. We need during transit of agriculture products from one location to other locations. Suppose a producer is producing the cereal grains in their field and they have to move the product produced to the processor. From there, from processor, it should be stored for certain duration. Till then it should reach to the consumers, and consumer still has to store the material, because if you are going to buy wheat flour, 5 kg of wheat flour, you cannot consume it in a single day. You have to store it in certain jar so that it can be remain useful for 1 month or 15 days. It depends on the number of persons in your family. And if we talk about the storage problem, storage is really responsible for 7% losses in post-harvest handling. 7% loss in post-harvest handling, if we consider the amount, seems to be a lower one. But if we talk about, if we convert into the in terms of production, then it will be a huge one. And it affects, the effect of this on rural economy is about 70%, where grains are stored at farm level. Okay, if we compare about the wastage, food wastage, how much food wastage is being done, I have taken the graph from FAO. Then it seems to be about third largest greenhouse gas emitter for producing the grains. If you talk about the locations, at what level the food is being stored, the first is on farm level, the second is at collection points serving to a number of farms, just like godowns. And at terminal points where grain is processed or moved forward in still larger bags, means when the collection points provide these inputs to processing industries where these can be stored for further processing, and after that, after processing or packaging, this will further move to the dealers and sub dealers and all that. Now we will talk about the deterioration caused by different insects and microorganisms. The first is deterioration in quality of grain caused by microorganisms. Second is alteration chemical constituents of grain owing to its metabolism. The third is insects and rodents cause damage by eating and contamination. I mean, the first thing is the microorganism deteriorates the quality, and the chemical properties are being changed due to metabolism of insects which are present in a stored material, and several portions can be damaged by direct eating and making contamination by urination and all that. If we classify the damages, we can classify into two terms. First is direct damage, means if we talk about insects, they consume germs and endosperm, means they consume it for their metabolic activities. And contamination may be with dead bodies, cast skin, excreta and odors, means these are direct damages which can be directly related to the insect and all that. Then tunneling in wooden parts, this is again a problem, because if we are creating a storage, then storage parts, storage structure is weakened by tunneling of these insects. And if we talk about the indirect damages, these are creating heating and migration of moisture, means when the insects respires, and during the respiration the heat is being released, and the migration of moisture from one place to other place that takes place. Then a problem is also there, the distribution of parasites to MNBs, means they can there are always a plenty of chances then parasites can be transported to the human. If we talk about the sources of infestation, the first infestation is field itself, because we are growing our crop not in a controlled conditions, mean in not in a room. We are growing our crop in fields, and field itself has dust. Plenty of chances are there for getting infestation. Second, if the field is good, after that, if your production or your produce is good and no infestation is there, and you are storing that into gunny bags, where you are reusing these gunny bags, means previously you have stored some grain into it and some infestation remains over there, means some eggs of insects may be there in the gunny bag itself. So you are putting a good grain into a bad container. It will also deteriorate the quality of material, and infestation will again start. Then infestation transport. Okay, now if your field is good, means field conditions are good, and you are using fresh gunnies for storing your grain. But when you are packing your material and transporting it to another location, at that time the truck, or you can say trolley, which you are using may have been used for transporting certain other material, means it might be involved for transporting some bad grains, means infested grain previously. If this has been done, means there are plenty of chances the insects may remain in the body of truck or trolley, and when you put your fresh good gunnies over there, then the gunnies will be infected. Infested go downs. Now all other, if we think that all three are good, means the field is good, infested gunnies, there are no possibility of gunnies, infested gunnies, transport is also good one. But if you are putting your material into a godown where you are storing a number of material, number of bags are being stored, some of the bags are already infested. If this kind of arrangement is there, you can just see a stack is over there and few other stacks are over there. If any of these stacks are infested, it means it can infest the remaining stacks over there. Infested stocks means number of stocks when you are creating, when you are putting a number of bags over there overall. Now if you talk about the type of insects, which kind of insects damages the grain, the first is major insects. These generally attack the food grain directly and has a capability to destroy the grain completely. For example, carpa larva is there, which can start eating the grain directly. Now, second category is minor insects. Minor insects, they don't have capability to attack on grain directly. But they can enjoy the grain which are already destroyed by major insects. Means if major insects are not there, minor insects are there, there is no problem. Means they cannot eat the perfect grain, sound grain directly. Because if grain is being damaged by the major insects, then minor insects came into the picture. They destroy the grain. This is the example. Now, incidental insects. These kinds of insects may or may not harm the store food grain, but they contaminate the grain with their presence. Means they do not harm, they do not consume, they do not eat anything, but because they are there, means contamination may be there, because you may find some dead bodies of butterflies and all that in the food grain. Means this has become contaminated. And sometimes parasites and predators insects are also there. Means if insects are there, incidental insects are there, and other insects are there which are living there in a grain storage structure, then certain other other animals, you can say other reptiles, which are consuming these insects. So due to presence of these parasites or predators, or we can say our grain will again be contaminated. This is the list of common insects of store grain. Rice weevil is there, capra beetle is there, a number of common names are there, and in which kind of crop these are generally found, a list is given, you can study it. Now, if we talk about the major responsible factor for deterring the grain, that is rat. If we look at the data, one rat consumes about 10 kg of grains in a year, whole year. But it contaminates more than 10 times what it actually eats with its urine and excreta. Means it is consuming 10 kg and it is contaminating 10 times, means 100 kg. 110 kg it is getting deteriorated. The grain is being deteriorated at this rate. Means the diet of one person is about 100 kg in a year. Means a rat can contaminate the diet of one person. It remains there for a year. And one rat drops about 125 to 150 pellets and 10 to 20 ml urine in a day. Besides shedding its plenty of hairs, rats also spread fatal diseases like plague, jaundice, rat bite fever, and typhoid. Number of diseases which are being carried by this contaminated grain. And there are 118 species of the rats found in India. A different kind of mouses are there. You can just see in the picture, from very small to XL size, it is there. And they are capable of consuming and deteriorating grain at a very faster rate. Now, if we talk about the rat control measures, because rat is a very major problem for storing a grain. The first thing is sanitation. Sanitation in houses and godowns is significantly helpful in reducing the rat menace. Every time we have to clean it, and if you find any kind of hole is there, any kind of rat, if you see moving, then you can take the measures that rat is there, you have to take the action. Definitely sanitation will help a lot. Then the waste grain should be removed. Grain sacks should be stored about 50 centimeter above the floor, and the grain should be protected with concrete, wire and sheet metal. Means the grain should be protected with concrete so that it should not climb over there. In order to avoid the entry of rats in houses and godowns, sometimes tin plate should be fitted at the door of windows at the bottom in such a way that once they are closed, no space is left for making entries by the rat. Normally, a rat do not enter when man is passing, but as the man goes from that place, then it start entering into the location. So doors and windows are such that, and there should not be any gap from the lower portion or you can say upper portion of the door. For the construction of rat proof godowns, following things should be considered. The first thing is the foundation should be kept as deep as possible, and plinth is constructed about 1 meter above the ground level. Means the foundation should be deep so that rat should not enter from the bottom side, and a good foundation should be there. And 1 meter height above the ground level means rat should not make a jump and get into the storage structure. So it should be at least 1 meter height should be there from the ground level. And L-shaped projection should be, L-shaped collar should be provided so that if it jumps, then it should not reach directly into the godowns. It should roll back to the ground itself. A godown should not have provision of steps. Normally, godowns are not being provided for the steps because rat easily climb on the steps. So when you want to do unload the grain or keep the grain on the truck, so you have to use certain other kind of facilities, so that these are temporary one. After the loading unloading, you can remove that step from there. Then fitting of wire netting to the drain pipe, it is very important because drain pipes are open and the rat always tries to enter from the drain pipe to the main go down. Sometimes what happens, because grain storage structures are quite large, so they don't have RCC roof over it. So normally we use corrugated sheet and special sheet for the ceiling. So what happens, when we use corrugated sheet or special sheet on the ceiling, then a gap always remains there. So we have to fill that gap, and we should, or sometimes we can use wire netting so that rat should not enter from it, because rat can also climb on wires. If wires are going to the air go down, then it will follow that, and after that, after reaching to the roof, it will try to enter into your go down. So it will always be better than anything which is very comfortable for the rat. Means if pillar is there, then it will try to climb on the pillar, and it will always try to climb on the ropes. Curtains, it can climb on it. So any kind of material which makes comfortable entry of rats should be avoided from the godowns. Sometimes chemicals are used to kill rats and mice, and these are called rodenticides, because we should restrict the entry of rat. That is the best solution. But sometimes what we see, some rats have get the entry into the godown, so we have to put some rodenticide into it so that rats can be killed. These rodenticide can be mixed with baits and fresh meats and rice peanuts, so that it can be consumed by the rat. Sometimes rat traps are also used for controlling the rats. The best way is to physically to make physical restriction to the rats. And this is all about our first lecture. Thank you. If you have any question, you can email me. I have written the email on the first slide. Thank you.